Welcome guys to a Forza Motorsport 7 gameplay video running on the RTX 480 Founders Edition. What you're watching here is the in-game benchmark, and after this benchmark you'll see that I've got the settings all set to ultra, or to the maximum they can be, which is quite surprising. I thought this was going to be the one game that was going to make the 480 kind of stumble a little bit. And you've got to bear in mind that Bandicam, which is what I'm using to screen record, will always take kind of a 10 to 15% performance hit on any game you're recording at the point in time. I've got the FPS reader at the top, and you'll see that it does kind of bounce between the 48-50 upwards, but most of the time it does stay around the 60 frame, which is what I'm locked at VSync. Run this 1440 as well, and I was amazed at how well it performs on the 4080. And to my surprisement, I'm using Precision X1 just to kind of manage and monitor the graphics card. It's not even over 35% power draw, maximum clock. Using every bit of the graphics card, and it's not even getting that warm. I think the highest I've had it get to whilst doing a race is in the 40s. That's 40C, but still just absolutely amazing graphics card. I know there's a lot of people out there saying that the 4080 isn't worth it and stuff. For my use case scenario, playing games or be it video editing and other bits, it's an absolute beast, and I was happy to pay out what I paid out for it. So we're going to get into this video. Gameplay, got the Australian Supercars Championship, and we're up in Mount Panorama, which is one of the most amazing tracks and probably one of my most favourite kind of touring car, albeit supercar series as well. And I do go through the camera modes as well, so you can kind of get a different feel for the different views and angles and graphics, just all around graphics, just absolutely phenomenal. So I hope you enjoy this gameplay. As always, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you in future content. Drayke out.